Welcome back into the New York studio for Proactive Investors. Joining me on Skype today is Rayne Steinberg and Jeff Dorman, both from Arca Funds. Great to have you both today. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Thanks for having us.
So the company is a cryptocurrency investment fund. What can you tell me about the fund and what makes Arca different?
Sure. Arca addresses cryptos both an asset class and an infrastructure. So we have products to allow institutional investors to invest in crypto safely. So that's with a heavy risk management overlay and really traditional Wall Street processes that institutional investors are accustomed to. And then on the product side, the infrastructure side, we're building a suite of products based on blockchain technology.
And Rayne, let's just get into your background really quickly. You had previously spent time at WisdomTree. What can you tell me about more of your background?
Sure. I co-founded WisdomTree in the early 2000s. And the idea at WisdomTree was to marry a novel index structure with, at the time, a innovative wrapper, which was the exchange-traded fund. So our idea was to really bring a kind of a heroic beat-the-market approach, investing approach, to the passive structure and all the great efficiencies of the ETF. And we see a lot of corollaries between that project and what's going on in crypto.
And what made you shift to the cryptocurrency market?
It was at WisdomTree. We were just hitting our stride in, we launched in 2006, so it's six years to set up. But then the financial crisis hit, and it alerted me to the fact that no matter what you're doing and how well your business is going, that you bear systemic risk and a lot of vicarious risk that you don't necessarily have control over. And then I read the Bitcoin white paper, and it was like a light bulb went off, a decentralization of trust, fixing double spend. These were all revolutionary things, but when I started getting involved with Bitcoin, it really wasn't ready for prime time and certainly not financial services. It took maturation to get there, and that was when we got into Arca.
And Jeff, you're the portfolio manager at Arca, but previously you had spent time at places like Merrill Lynch and Citadel. Can you go more into your background for me?
Yeah, sure. I have a more traditional Wall Street background, started as an investment banker at Lehman Brothers. Then I moved to the sell side and became a trader, trading high yield, distressed and reorg equities at Merrill Lynch, and then went to the buy side. I worked for Citadel and a couple of smaller hedge funds. And then in 2013, I left the asset management business to help run a fintech company called Harvest Exchange, where I was the COO for 5 years building technology products for the asset management industry. So I've been in and around trading, asset management, and technology my whole career.
The company is experiencing a bit of news. It's gearing up to launch its Arca hybrid token, potentially the first SEC-approved stable token. We saw some stable tokens facing some hurdles recently, one called Basis. What can you tell me about how you're planning to launch your stablecoin?
Sure. So our approach is to use the fund structure that's regulated by the Investment Company Act of 1940. So this is the same fund structure that underpins ETFs. And the novel approach we're taking is to take that well-understood and well-regulated fund structure and then have it represented in crypto or on the blockchain. So think of the blockchain replacing the ETF wrapper. So all the great things that you can do with those regulated products, but instead of being tied to an exchange ecosystem, you would live on the blockchain.
So now what is the timeline to launch the stablecoin?
That is a great question. This is in the hands of the SEC. So we had our first meeting with them, and we went very early because we wanted to have a real collaborative approach with the regulators. We take the stance that this is novel and not obvious or, you know, easy to do. And the regulators are trying to work with the tools that they have, but they need people to work within the confines of this system. So we're working with these investment company acts, which weren't necessarily designed to address blockchain, but going them to them early, trying to assure them that what we're looking to do is give them the tools and products that will allow the investor protections, you know, their mandate, to actually launch products that work in this ecosystem that do that. So that first conversation was very early, but the body language and the questions that we got back were very positive, and it seemed to be a very collaborative approach they took. So we're cautiously optimistic that it won't be a very long approval process, But, you know, they will move at their own pace.
Well, looking forward to hearing about those meetings with the SEC. Just want to get to one thing. Today we saw a rally in the crypto markets, Bitcoin up more than 20% from its recent low. What do you see as the future of traditional finance and crypto?
Sure. I think in terms of where crypto fits within traditional finance, I think it's important to recognize that it's not either or, right? Investors are still diversifying their portfolios like they would across any asset classes. So you're probably not going to be 100% equities. You're probably not going to be 100% fixed income, and you're almost certainly not going to be 100% crypto. So within a portfolio allocation, crypto does fit because it offers an uncorrelated return and a different risk return profile than some other asset classes. With regard to seeing 20% moves, the reality is when you're dealing with immature markets and immature asset classes, not to mention the entire size of the cryptocurrency market is only around $120 billion, it's susceptible to a lot of large moves that may give pause to some traditional investors who are not used to seeing swings like this. But it's just par for the course when you're talking about new technology and new assets that still haven't quite gotten to that mature level of steady buy and steady sell interest on both sides at all times.
Well, I thank you very much both for your insights today. Very much looking forward to following the Arca story. Thanks very much and happy holidays.
You too. Thanks for having us. Too.